Everyone, welcome to Spectrum Classes. This is our another lab activity video, and in this video we are going to discuss about the concept of surface tension. You might have encountered all such examples in your daily life, which I have shown you here. How these drops form, here you can see. Another example, this beaker is filled up to the brims, and if I add more water to this, that water doesn't come out from this beaker. If I touch the surface, how it reacts, you can see over here. Here you can see a paper clip is sinked in the beaker. This suggests its high density, but at the same time, if I put this clip slowly on the surface of this water, it starts floating. How this occurs, how the small objects of certain shape can float over the surface of the water. So here I'll just give you the explanation how the surface tension works and how these phenomena can be explained based on the surface tension. Suppose this is a container or a beaker which is filled with water. Here is this blue color represents the water, and outside this blue color we are having air or the other medium. In between water and air there is an interface, or we can say surface of the liquid, and the molecules on the surface of the liquid, how they behave, how these phenomena can be explained based on the surface tension, that we are going to discuss in this video. This can be explained based on two different mechanisms. So one is force per unit length and the other one is energy per unit area. If you are a student of physics, then you can understand if we multiply force with the length with the length, then we get work done per unit area. That work done is considered as energy here. So these two actually related to each other, but these are explained in a different manner. So first we are going to discuss about the force per unit length. Suppose an imaginary line is drawn over the surface of the liquid, then the molecules nearby this line, force acting on this line perpendicularly just because of the molecules present nearby this line in either of the direction. So suppose the molecules present this side, they start acting in this manner. It is at right angle to this line, and if some of the molecules are on this side, so they are started acting in this direction at right angle to this line. Similarly, some more molecules which are present, I just for the convenience I have shown this end on end, but they can be at different points also. But the important thing is that there is no force acting up in the upward direction and in the downward direction. This is parallel to the surface. Once again, I'll just explain. If imaginary line is drawn on the surface of the liquid, the force acting in the plane parallel to the surface, right, not in the upward direction, not in the downward direction, and is right angle to the line, the molecules exerting force on this line at right angle in either of the direction. So the magnitude of that force per unit length, if we consider that this line or length of this line is 1 centimeter. In CGS and SI units, the unit of this force per unit length is Newton per meter, and in CGS system it is dynes per centimeter. So if we are talking in terms of CGS system, so suppose this is my 1 centimeter line, and the magnitude of the force which is applying on this surface equal to the surface tension. Here the surface tension is represented by capital T, and sometimes it is also represented by gamma. Whichever is given in your textbook, you can refer that. This is the formula for the surface tension in terms of force per unit length is equal to F upon L, and its unit is Newton per meter. If you are talking in terms of CGS, then it will be dynes per centimeter, right? If we are having this liquid as a water, Then I'll just so the surface tension of water is 72.8 dynes per centimeter at 20 degree centigrade and 72 dynes centimeter at 25 degree centigrade. So what you infer from this statement means surface tension changes or decreases on increasing the temperature. So why it happens so? Because on increasing the temperature, kinetic energy of the molecules increases. Therefore, the surface tension of the surface molecules decreases. This is one inference which we have made from this statement, that on increasing the temperature, surface tension decreases. And it also depends on the impurities present in the water, and it also depends on medium which is present outside this surface. Secondly, this statement can also be considered as 72 dynes force would be taken to break the surface film of 1 centimeter long. As I shown you here in this example. In other terms, or in energy per unit area, this energy per unit area is also known as surface energy. So how this is going to be explained? This is on the basis of the molecular action. So suppose two different type of forces acting. So one is cohesive forces. Cohesive forces means forces which are acting in between same type of molecules. So here water molecules. Suppose these blue bubbles shows the water molecules. Cohesive forces, the forces which are acting in between the same kind of molecules. Whereas adhesive forces which are acting in between different type of molecules. So here this blue is water and this gray is air. This can also be explained here. This is water and here this black line shows the glass molecule. So here is again adhesive forces. So this adhesive and cohesive forces play role while we are considering the energy per unit area term. Suppose we are having water molecules. Some of the molecules are inside the liquid and some are nearby the surface. So if we are considering one by one the molecules which are present inside the liquid, then this molecule is attracted from all the sides by same kind of molecules from all sides. These are balanced. So net force over this molecule is zero. If we are talking about the surface molecules, here the surface molecule is having half of this molecule is inside the liquid and half of the molecule is in contact with the air molecule. Since air molecules are far apart, they are not so close, this molecule is experiencing imbalanced forces. And these are the adhesive forces. In comparison to this liquid, they are very lesser. Because of this imbalanced forces, this surface molecule experience imbalance forces which are acting inward. Just because of this imbalance forces, the surface molecule possess higher potential energy. Suppose this molecule is going inside, then this molecule from the bulk starts approaching towards the surface. So as it starts approaching the surface, it has to work against this inward force. In that case, the potential energy of the surface molecules increases. And if the potential energy of the surface increases, and as we know, the system is stable in equilibrium when the potential energy is less, these surface molecules or liquid surface will try to have minimum number of molecules on the surface. That is why it acquire a perfectly or nearly spherical shape, just because of that, to minimize the surface energy. Here you can see, that is why we have drops in spherical shape for the liquids. The surface possesses larger energy than the interior and thus behaves in some respect as if it were a stretched film or membrane under tension. Video is very important from the Viva point of view related to the experiment to determine the surface tension of a given liquid using a stagmometer. And the applications of having surface tension is the cleaning action of soap, water striders, how they walk on the water surface, small objects float over the surface of the water, how this drop forms, lower meniscus, how that forms based on the adhesive and cohesive forces. Contact angle, wet properties, these are all the examples of surface tension. I hope you understand the concept of the surface tension. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel, give me a thumbs up. Thank you all.